Wissam Qawasmi's apartment overlooks Israel's separation wall. But he says this view could get worse. The Israeli Housing Ministry has started the process to approve 9,000 new houses. They form part of a new illegal Israeli settlement that would cut off the East Jerusalem neighborhoods north of the wall from those to its west. That would prevent the development of the most central metropolis in any future Palestinian state.
I bought this apartment because there was some sort of an open-air view and not a cramped neighborhood. But if the open space is gone, I will be forced to leave. I also expect violent clashes if the settlement is built.
If approved, the settlement would be built on this empty land in East Jerusalem. It fell under Israeli occupation in 1967 and used to be an airport until violence in the year 2000 led to its closure. Now, the area is isolated from its surrounding by the Israeli separation wall. But a new settlement could mean the demolition of nearby buildings, including the one where Wissam lives. The U.S. Mideast peace plan proposed by President Donald Trump in January suggests this area would be a part of a future Palestinian state. Palestinians rejected the plan, saying it doesn't meet the minimum requirement for statehood and takes away an additional 30% of their lands. Under the plan, illegal Israeli settlements will stay in place. In the weeks leading up to elections, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has been announcing more units in Israeli settlements in the occupied West Bank, including East Jerusalem. Both Netanyahu and his rival Benny Gantz have promised to annex Israeli settlements. Scholars say Israeli politicians are trying to appeal to voters who are shifting increasingly to the right.
There's competition between Blue and White Party headed by Benny Gantz and the Likud Party by Netanyahu, who incites more violence against Palestinians. Members of Gantz's party are not providing an alternative to Netanyahu, but they are trying to be more radical than him when it comes to the Palestinians and the Arabs.
With the US and Israel having the closest relations ever, Palestinian officials say they're pushing European countries to recognize the Palestinian state.
The Palestinians feel lonely and alone in such a fight, since everybody is there to please Trump and everybody is there to please Netanyahu. And obviously in the hype of the so-called normalization that Arab countries are committing themselves to, Palestinians feel desperate for support.
Palestinians say Israeli plans on the ground, including settlement expansions, have been advancing for decades. But with each round of elections, the main contenders rush to make new announcements that end up stripping Palestinians of more lands and making their dream of statehood even more difficult. Nida Ibrahim, Al Jazeera, the occupied West Bank.